everybody, Sam Strains here. Welcome back to the railway and welcome to another locomotive review. Today I decided there was just enough time left in the year to do another Thomas and Friends loco, so today we're going to be looking at Toby, the tram engine. Now, amazingly, I've had loads and loads of requests to show Toby, and I wouldn't have had him down as a particularly popular character, but I think apart from Oliver, I think Toby's probably the most popularly requested engine. So I've got to do him. He's at number 7, as you can see, really lovely looking chap. And so today I'm going to be opening him, reviewing him, and then getting him running later on, which is the part we all like. So let's get him open and see what he's like, shall we? And yes, Toby is in the same old packaging that we're all used to, and you can just about see him inside there. I do love the face on this one. I think this is probably my favourite face. So I'm not going to go on about the packaging or anything because we've seen it all loads of times. So I'm going to get him straight out, and yes, I've cut the back again. And look how easy this is. Just grab him straight out. There we go. Okay, well, I better show the instructions because I always show those. And I personally find them interesting. I don't know if anybody else does. Probably not. I'm probably the only one. Yep, here it is. You can see the mechanisms there. They've missed out his face for some reason, but maybe that's because it looked just too terrifying to put onto the diagram. But yep, that is all the different parts and things, as you can tell, and that's useful to know, especially when you want to service them. So, yep, perfect. But let's get him out then. Here comes Toby in his little plastic sleeve, and he is tiny, isn't he? He's a little engine. And a very interesting looking engine as well, of course. A steam tram, I believe, isn't he? But there he is anyway, number 7, and just look at that face. It's just, I don't know what it is about that face, but I love it. And he's quite a nicely detailed model as well, I must say. So I'm going to get him reviewed in just a second, but first of all, here's one or two shout-outs and also a little bit of history on Toby. So hello to Vlog That Train 31, Sodor Arts Productions, and Shauna Emery. Thank you all very much for getting in touch. So unlike the other engines on Sodor, Toby is actually a tram, although he does run on steam and not diesel. He was based on the GER C53 steam trams, and he arrived on Sodor in 1951. Since then, he's worked with his coaches Henrietta and Victoria, as well as his luggage van called Elsie. Because Toby has been around for so long, he's very wise and he has very good control even over the most troublesome of trucks. And he's also very enthusiastic about his work, but sadly he can't really pull as much as the other engines can. Just because of his size, he is very small of course, and his age, he's getting on a little bit in years. He was built in 1914 then, meaning that this year he celebrated his 103rd birthday. Blimey, happy birthday Toby. Anyway, let's move on to having a look at his detail then. So there he is then, Toby the tram engine, looking very, very smart indeed up against the white background. And as always, I'm going to talk about the face to start with, and as I already said, I love the face on this one. And I don't know a lot about the character, but to me, just by looking at that face, you can tell so much about him, and I just think it's a brilliant face. So I think definitely this is my favourite face of all of the Bachmann Thomas range, and you can just tell that he's an odd bod, can't you? And I bet the other engines find him a bit strange as well, because he really doesn't look like them, does he? He's totally different looking to all the other engines. Anyway, let's have a look at some of his details then. As you can see, there's lots of painted work. You've got his number 7 right in the middle here, and you've got this lovely wooden panelling effect, which I'm sure Toby must be very proud of. And even though the inside of Toby is all sort of solid, you can't see through onto the inside, you have got these handrails which have been painted on, and unfortunately the paint really has come off quite badly on those, and I thought to start with that might be just a quality problem maybe, but I found out that the actual packaging had done that. These little handrails are just behind the little sort of finger holes on the packaging, so yeah, I think that's the first time the dodgy bubble packaging has caused damage to a model, and it's not major damage, but I suppose it would be quite fiddly to repaint those if you wanted to, and you know, as a kid you're not going to be wanting to do that sort of thing, but nonetheless it is a nicely painted detail. Up on the roof you can see he's got a bell, and even modern trams have sort of bell sounds, don't they? So Toby's no different, he's got one. And then he's got the chimney here, I suppose that's his chimney where he gets rid of his exhaust fumes. Another feature I really like about the Toby model is that he's got these lamps, and they're really quite nice looking lamps, good detail. There's one on the back there, and of course you might have seen the one on the front just above his face there, which is very nice to see. His buffer beams are fairly sort of minimal, you've just got the regular
black painted buffers and a little coupling hook there. And then you've got what look a bit like cow catchers on either end, with the coupling hooks for the actual wagons and things that you might want to pull sticking out. And that's quite interesting. And then on the side you've got these sort of moulded steps. I suppose they might be steps, or it's more like a ladder, isn't it? So that maybe workmen or something would be able to climb up. I would assume if he was picking up passengers, he'd probably come into a station, wouldn't he? And they'd be able to walk straight on. But if he's not at a station, I suppose those steps could be used. But yeah, as you can tell, he's quite a nicely detailed model. He's got quite a lot of detail on him, really, hasn't he? I mean, the wooden panelling effect is very nicely done, and I think that does quite a lot for the model. So yeah, that's Toby. That's all I'm going to talk about on the detail. So let's get him down onto the track, and we'll see how nicely he runs, shall we? Okay, I think Toby's looking forward to this as well. So there he is then, there's Toby down onto the track, and of course in real life it would be absolutely fine for an engine like Toby to just run by themselves as a tram. But today, just because it is a review, I did think he ought to pull at least something, so I've set up this little train for him. It's just a couple of little coaches, the Troublesome Trucks and the Thomas and Friends Utilities van, so that ought to prove that he can at least pull something other than just his own weight. But let's give him a little try on the controller then, let's give him a little bit of juice and see how he goes, and from what I remember he's a very, very good performer. So come on Toby, show us what you can do. Just turning him up now. Oh, he's going backwards first. And as you can see, that is a superb slow performance. Look at that. It's wonderful. The only real gripes I have on the performance with this is that he's got, let's see here, he's got six wheels, but only four of them are driven, and only four of them have pickups. Now, if this was a proper model, and there is a proper model of Toby coming out, well, it won't be called Toby, it will be the real thing, but I would assume that one would have all-wheel drive and all-wheel pickups, and that means that it will perform a lot better. But Toby's not bad at all, but, you know, don't get me wrong, he doesn't cut out or anything, but he doesn't have a massive amount of power because he's not that heavy. But hopefully he's going to be able to pull that train we've got for him today. Cool. Okay, let's put you on the front then so you can see his eyes moving, because of course the eyes do work on Toby. Okay, a little bit more juice now the camera's on him. Oh, yep, his eyes have looked over one way. Let's bring him back and send them the other way. Oh, there we go. So what a cool feature that is. I do love the fact that their eyes move. And, you know, when I was a kid, I can just imagine how much more exciting these would have been with moving eyes. So it's a great idea. Right, that works very well. Okay, let me take the camera off then, and we'll get coupled up, I think. Here we are, this is what the camera looks like, if anybody's interested. Just got to switch it off. There we go. Take the wagons and things off. There we go, move them out of the way. And, yep, let's get him going then. Did I change direction? No, I didn't. Right, let's go and couple. Right, slow down, Toby. Don't couple too hard. You've got passengers there to keep happy. Right, there we go. Right, hopefully he's coupled then, and I'm going to pull those away in just a second. Well, Toby is. And don't forget to keep an eye out on the layout today. There's lots of other engines out there to spot. They all have something in common except for one, so see if you can tell me which one is the odd one out. But for now, I'll get Toby running, and then I'll show you which other ones are going to be running, actually running with him. So that's it. Good boy, Toby. Oh, you've cut out on the points. You see? So if he had all six pickups, that might not have happened, but let's just give him a nudge. There we go. Oh, nobody saw that. Don't worry about it, Toby. Right, and he's a good slow runner as well. That's half speed. It's still nice and slow, so it means he's a bit like an old man. Okay, and elsewhere on the line, I didn't really want to run all Thomas and Friends locos today, so I thought we'd have a change. So here comes a little 060 tank engine. It's called a Barclay 060, and it's pulling just a little cute goods train. So here it comes. Let's see here. Just four wagons and a brake. So I hope you enjoy seeing that one run. I've not run that one in quite a long time. So, yep, everyone who's watching today, you're lucky to be seeing that one run. And actually, this next loco that's on the inside line, although it isn't actually in Thomas, there is one a lot like it in Thomas. It goes by a different name. But this one is a terrier that goes by the name of Whitechapel. But see if you can tell me what the terrier is called in Thomas. But here she comes in this lovely sort of umber livery. And she's got some of the small passenger coaches, just like the ones Toby's pulling. And a little Southern Railways brake van on the end. So enjoy the running session. I'm going to go around the room and show you what's going on. Here comes Toby now with his little train. He's just about to pass the other tank engine. Oh, there's just something about him, isn't there? I don't know what it is. Let's just say he's square. Ha ha ha. But there he goes, off into the distance. I think he's quite happy that there's snow on the ground today. He's always wanted to run in the snow, I think. He looks happy enough anyway, doesn't he? And he's not struggling with his train, which is good to hear. Yeah, he's doing a good job.
I've just had to speed old Whitechapel up because she stopped on Gordon's Hill, so I think these coaches are a little bit too much for her, but I'm going to keep them on and see if she can do it this time. So let's go to Gordon's Hill and see if Whitechapel can make it up there this time.
I had to give her a little bit of a push last time, so let's see if she does it better now. It was just here she stopped last time. Oh, she has stopped. Right, I better give her a push. Do you know what? I didn't touch him then. He's just started again. Oh, I'm glad I caught that on camera. So I didn't actually push him, just to be clear. Wow. Well, that worked out good. Let's not forget Toby. There he is. He's not struggling, as you can see, on Gordon's Hill. Oh my goodness. What's happened here? The tank engine has ended up with the brake van on the front of the train. Obviously the coupling failed on that... Oops! Somebody doesn't like that brake van.
Oh dear, I'm going to have to get that out of the way, aren't I, before Toby comes. Well, it's Rocky to the rescue. I managed to get it loaded onto the crane. And these guys are going to take it away now, where it will be repaired. So there it goes. And I've just noticed another disaster happen, so we're going to look into this. I just noticed a big puff of smoke come out of this Whitechapel loco, and then she stopped completely, so I don't know whether I've overdone it with the coaches or what, but she shouldn't have died, I wouldn't have thought. So I'm going to take her to bits and see what's going on, but I've got to say, you wouldn't have caught Triang locos doing things like that. Not good, is it? Okay, I'll be right back. I'll let you know what the situation is on her. Right, well, the armature had actually jammed up. I've managed to unjam it now, but I think the motor might have had it, to be honest. So I'm just going to power it up and see what happens, and if it dies a death, it dies a death. But yeah, Hornby, stop using those nasty cheap motors. Right, let's give it some juice and see what happens, shall we? Whoa. Yeah, the armature's dead. It's jammed it up, basically. And it smells of egg, interestingly. So yeah, no more Terrier, unfortunately. I won't be buying a new one either, because I've never liked the noise it made while it ran. Anyway, let's go back to Toby, I'll put another engine on.
Okay, I've put a Jinty on, so sorry about that. Slight technical problem there, but you know, you can't be surprised. You know, I've seen the nasty motors Hornby have used in some of their models. And that one had never impressed me, so... Yep, less than a year old, and maybe I shouldn't have put so many coaches on it, but it's not exactly a lot, is it?
And now for my ratings then, for the very lovely Bachmann Toby. Detail, 7 out of 10. Yes, the detail isn't fantastic on this, but I think there is more of it on Toby than there have been on the other models, so I've given it a bit of a higher score there. Performance, 8 out of 10. The slow speed performance, I can't fault at all. But there are a couple of things, you know, it's only got 2 driven axles and not 3, and it's only got pickups on 2 of the axles rather than all 3. And also he's a little bit noisy and he's not too heavy, so he doesn't do a great job of pulling big loads. But as you can tell, what he's pulling today is absolutely fine. Character though, 10 out of 10. As I've already said, I love his face and I just think Toby's a fab character. So I've given it 10 out of 10 there. He's brilliant. He looks just like he does in the show, in my opinion, although I'm no expert. Build quality then, 9 out of 10. There was that small amount of damage on one of his handrails. But apart from that, I can't really fault it. It seems to be a good, sturdy model, so 9 out of 10 there. Value then, I paid £50 for mine, which is alright, you know, but it is quite a bit, I would say, for an 060, so 7 out of 10, not too bad. Overall then, that gives him 8.68 out of 10, and let's put him into the rankings. There we go, 20 seconds, just above the Dean Goods, and just below the Railroad Evening Star.
Blimey, well, that was an eventful running session. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. That was my review of Toby. And he is a lovely engine, isn't he? It's just nice to see something a bit different, you know. It's not just a regular steam engine. He's something very, very unusual. So I've enjoyed looking at that. As always, if you enjoy the video as well, please feel free to leave it a like or even a comment. And if you'd like to, check out the Facebook or Twitter pages, which are at facebook.com/samstrains or twitter.com/samstrains. It would be lovely to see you over there. And don't forget, if you want to have any pictures up on the Wall of Fame, here it is, this is the Wall of Fame, you can just email them to me at samstrains@outlook.com and I'll print them out and put them up for you. But for now, folks, once again, thank you for watching, thank you for your support, and I will see you all very soon. Cheers, everybody.